And here is the Writer's Almanac for Sunday. It's the 23rd of May, 2021. It is World Turtle Day, celebrating the creature who first appears in fossils of the Triassic period 220 million years ago. They live long, their cells don't age like ours do. The largest turtle, the leatherback sea turtle, up to 2,000 pounds, 6.5 feet long. And it's the birthday of Margaret Wise Brown, Brooklyn, New York, 1910. She'd already published 20 children's books when one day she looked around her house, started writing a poem. In the great green room, there was a telephone and a red balloon and a picture of the cow jumping over the moon. And that resulted in Goodnight Moon, one of the best-selling children's books of all time. It was on this day in 1911 the New York Public Library was dedicated, second largest public library in the U.S., right behind the Library of Congress, the fourth largest in the world. 1879, the first state-sponsored veterinary school established at Iowa State on this date. It's the birthday of the poet Jane Kenyon, 1947, Ann Arbor, Michigan. Her father was a jazz pianist, toured with dance bands. Her mother was a nightclub singer. She was a student at the University of Michigan when she took a poetry writing class from the poet Donald Hall. They fell in love. They married. When she graduated, moved out to New Hampshire. They were married for 23 years. There on the farm where they lived, they woke in the morning, they had coffee, took the dog for a walk, wrote poetry, took a nap, read the mail, played ping pong, ate dinner, and then read books, and then went to bed. Jane Kenyon, whose advice to writers was, be a good steward of your gifts, protect your time, feed your inner life, avoid too much noise, read good books, have good sentences in your ears, be by yourself as often as you can, walk, take the phone off the hook, work regular hours. And it's the birthday of Margaret Fuller, born in Cambridgeport, Massachusetts, 1810. She became a close friend of Ralph Waldo Emerson, became the first editor of the Transcendentalist journal, The Dial. Also an advocate for women's rights and women's education. Ralph Waldo Emerson said of Margaret Fuller, being in her company is like being set in a large place. You stretch your limbs and dilate to your utmost size. Here's a poem by Jane Kenyon entitled Thinking of Madame Bovary. The first hot April day, the granite step was warm, flies droned in the grass. When a car went past, they rose in unison, then dropped back down. I saw that a yellow crocus bud had pierced a dead oak leaf, then opened wide. How strong its appetite for the luxury of the sun! Everyone longs for love's tense joys and red delights. And then I spied an ant dragging a ragged, disembodied wing up the warm brick wall. It must have been the Methodist in me that leaned forward, preceded by my shadow, to put a twig just where the ant was struggling with its own desire. Thinking of Madame Bovary, poem by Jane Kenyon, from The Boat of Quiet Hours, published by Grey Wolf Press and used by permission here on The Writer's Almanac. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.